अजून थोडं चांगलं
Indica, or the free tree of India, grows all over the Indian subcontinent. Neem is derived from the Sanskrit word nimba, which means to bestow good health. The Atharva Veda refers to neem as sarva roga nivarini, one that could cure all ailments.
Since ancient times, the medicinal properties of neem were known to Indians. Rishis and sages have encouraged to plant neem trees as they were beneficial to man and animals. The ladies use neem in their cosmetics. Our rajas use neem in their daily life as a protection from diseases. Neem is a total village dispensary. Every part of it is beneficial and can be used externally and internally. Take for instance the neem twig, which is a toothbrush and toothpaste. The leaves are an excellent source of fodder. They not only help in digestion but also expel worms. The leaves help keep insects, pests and bugs away. The flowers of neem have a cooling effect and are used in balancing of the body heat and checking cough formation. The bark is very useful for fevers, loss of appetite and worm infections. A simple decoction made with the bark and water in the ratio 1:3 heals wounds and cures skin diseases. Neem also has great spiritual significance. For the devotees of Sai Baba, this neem tree at Shirdi is sacred, as it is believed that Baba spent most of his time under this neem tree. Neem leaves are the weapon of goddess Muthu Mariamman to ward off diseases. Even today, measles and chickenpox are treated and cured by neem. The Neem Foundation hosted Neem 2002, the 7th World Neem Conference in Mumbai, where delegates from 30 countries participated.
There are so many NEEM stalwarts in this room today, whose knowledge, if valued and tapped productively, could result in halting global degradation and erosion of soil, reclaiming deserts and wastelands, producing safer food for our children, storing food in safer ways. Now is the time when NEEM research results for over 3 decades and 7 international and world events. They need to be translated into at least 7 tangible products that we can offer the world, that should find acceptance worldwide.
NEEM and its mode of action is that of a soft pesticide. If you say the other pesticides, synthetic ones, are strong pesticides or hard pesticides, then this is connected with high toxicity also to human beings, domestic animals, and so on. In the future, of course, perhaps after 50 years, most of the synthetic materials which are on the market just now will be forbidden because they have too many side effects also.
At the Central Arid Zone Research Institute in Jodhpur, scientists have uncovered the secret of neem. It is a powerful antibacterial, antifungal and antiviral agent, which makes it a total antibiotic. The fear of toxic residues in food products associated with the use of chemical pesticides has led to an enthusiasm for biopesticides made from neem, which is eco-friendly, effective and affordable. The neem seeds act as a repellent against insects and pests. Neem cake is a natural pesticide which protects the plant root. It is also an excellent organic manure. In Ayurveda, which is the science of health and healing, neem is one of the main ingredients.
What Ayurveda told around 5,000 years ago is something which is now being accepted by the modern science all over. Neem is the best example of that. Neem, it has been said in Ayurveda to increase the oja of what is now known as immunity. And immunity is increased by neem is proved beyond doubt. Along with that, neem is also anti-infective, it's also antibacterial. And hence, this combination of increasing the immunity and being antibacterial and antiviral makes it probably one of the most prospective plant to be explored for HIV/AIDS.
For building up immunity, maybe the leaves or the bark, either the fresh leaves juice or the decoction of bark has to be used in the dose of maybe around 30 to 40 ml in a day, maybe once or twice. It can be used with honey. You can add certain other excipients to it to make it more palatable. Neem has been found to be very useful in many of the disorders of the buccal cavity. That means when the oral hygiene is expected to be taken over. In diabetes mellitus, especially in type 2 diabetes mellitus, neem has been found to be effective. Neem is also used for many of the skin disorders. We have tried neem oil, whereby we have seen that the slough of the infected wound gets cleared. So it acts as a local anti-infective agent. It acts as a slough clearing agent. It also acts as a healing agent for the wound. Everybody is using neem, especially for skin disorders. Whenever there are boils, whenever there are pimples, whenever there is some fungal infection, whenever there is some eruption on the skin of the human system, probably the first herb that you think of is neem.
Companies are now using neem oil and neem leaf extracts for cosmetics like facial creams, face packs, toothpaste, soaps and shampoos.
There is a lot of misconception that neem has been patented by America and that nobody can make any neem products. Now let us get this one thing very clear. America or any other country can only patent a process by which they make a neem product. It is absurd to think that any country or company can claim a right over nature. Neem belongs to all of us, to the whole world.
50% of the neem trees worldwide grow in India. Neem is an undemanding tree and thrives on dry, stony, clay and shallow soils. Neem is a natural air purifier. It exhales large quantities of oxygen and keeps the oxygen level in the atmosphere balanced. Neem's ability to withstand extreme heat and water pollution is well known. We in India have little respect for the neem tree. We take it for granted because it has been in abundance in our country. But that may soon be a thing of the past. It is time we woke up to this simple truth. The neem tree is capable of healing our wounded earth. We must protect it.
Like that.